Hello friends, in this video we're going to talk about battered baby syndrome. Now it is a child abuse, also known as CAFI syndrome, CAMPES syndrome and infant traumatic stress syndrome. First of all, the definition of a battered child. Now it is the child who received a repetitive physical injuries which are as a result of non-accidental violence produced by parents or guardian. Here is a child which has received repetitive physical injuries by their parents or guardians, and the injuries are non-accidental. Now, what does it mean non-accidental? Non-accidental means these injuries are deliberately inflicted on the child, which may include by hitting, by kicking, by burning, or by biting, or by choking. So these are the injuries which are classified under non-accidental violence. Moving on to the features. Now we have child and parents or guardians. Now for child, usually these children age is less than 3 years. Now more common in male child, and usually these childs are illegitimate or unwanted children. And position, usually these are eldest or youngest in the family. Parents and guardian, usually these are young parents, unmarried couples with low socioeconomic status and lower level of education. Parents themselves are victims of battering during childhood. So these are some features of child and parent or guardians. Now clinical presentation. Now there will always be a discrepancy between the nature of injuries and explanation offered by the parents. There will not be a proper explanation of the nature of the injuries given by the parents. They will explain something to the doctor, but that will not be a proper explanation for the how the injuries have happened to the child. Also, there will be a gap between the injuries and the medical attention taken by the parents. The injury happened last month and they are seeking medical advice after a month. So that can't be explained by anything. Let's see some injuries which are classically associated with the battered baby syndrome. First of all, soft tissue injuries. Now there will be multiple bruises, abrasions and laceration present over the baby's body. Now lacerations of oral mucosa along with labial frenulum of lower lip, these are characteristic features for the battered baby syndrome. Also there will be present of slap marks, lash marks, knuckle punches, pinch marks, butterfly bruises and six penny bruises on the body of the baby. In the CNS injuries, there will be shaken baby syndrome. Now it is due to the violent shaking of the baby. Now with violent shaking of the baby, there can be subdural hemorrhage in the babies, multiple subdural hemorrhages, retinal hemorrhages and encephalopathy. Skeletal injuries, long bone fractures, skull fractures, rib fractures, these are classically seen with battered baby syndrome. Also these fractures will be present at different stages of healing. So there will be callus formation, and which will be callus will be on different stages for each of the different fractures. Then comes burns. Now burns, these are small circular pitted burns indicating deliberate stabbing of cigarette ends on the skin. And also there will be injuries to the hollow organs like spleen, liver is also very common. As for treatment, these children needs psychological and emotional support in addition to the symptomatic treatment for different kind of injuries they sustain. Apart from examination point of view that we have discussed in this video, now let's just discuss how battered child syndrome is a major problem all across the world and in India, where it is believed to have very few cases, but reality is far, far away from our eyes. The WHO estimates that 40 million children are subjected to abuse and neglect around the world. Most of the developed countries have their own reporting and surveillance system and have data on child battering. But in developing countries, including India, there is a lack of data regarding the extent of child battering that takes place within households or institutions. Now, in India, there is no way to know how many cases of battered child syndrome occurs every year, as they are hardly reported and there is no system in place for such surveillance. Over a period of 10 years, there were just a handful of cases reported in various journals from all over India. When such children are discharged back to the same household where they suffered abuse, many times they end up dead. In 2007, India published a report on one of the largest surveys done on child abuse and found that 2 out of every 3 children were physically abused and 88.6% of them suffered at the hands of their own parents. In India, the culture of corporal punishment is still viewed as normal, and when does that cross the line and becomes child abuse is not watched closely by any agency. What happens within the walls of someone's home, be it child abuse, is not considered as a neighbor's problem, and thus most child battering cases go unnoticed and unreported. With poverty and lack of health care threatening survival, child battering does not receive much attention, and that's the sad reality of our society. That's it for the video, guys. Hope you liked it. See you next time. Bye bye. Thank you.